Hello, I'm Atuba George. Now, this is a new week, and I bless God for what He's doing in your life through this broadcast. I'm grateful to God. Like I told you, and I always think it and say it, I appreciate the fact that you take out time to watch this broadcast. And those of you that give us feedback on how the broadcast is affecting your life, we cherish your feedback, and we do pray for you all the time. Praise God. Because the only way God can bless you is when He gives you His word. See, God, you don't see God. See, John told us, no man has ever seen God. So how do you know God exists? Through His word. How do you know God is in a place? Through His voice. Praise God. When the word of God comes to you, then you know that God is in that place. Like I've said, there may be wind, there may be storm, there may, whatever you think, you know, people can be falling all over. If there is no word, then you know that it is not God that was operating in that place. God will do all that stunt just for Him to speak to you. That's the most important thing. So if you see all that stunt and no word comes to you, then it wasn't God. That's a fact. Praise God. Now, this week we're going to be looking at something very important, and I need all your attention this week because this is so important. We're going to be talking about, I don't know how to title this, but we're talking about prophecies and how they come to pass. See, do I need to do anything for prophecy that have been spoken about me to come to pass? What do I need to do, or how should I behave, or is there just more beyond God saying this is what's going to happen? Praise God. So I'm sharing this so that you will understand the things God have said to you, how they are going to come to pass, the things God have said concerning your environment, concerning our nation. How are these things going to come to pass? What role do we play, you know, for these prophecies to come to pass? Now, that's what I'm going to be talking to you about this whole week. Praise God. And I believe that at the end of it, you see, the essence of the word of God coming to you is to bring peace to your hearts. See, quietness and assurance. Not just peace of, well, I don't know what will happen, but no, but the peace that comes with assurance. Why are you at peace? Because I know God who have spoken is surely going to fulfill His word. Now, He said in Isaiah chapter 55, He says, "So shall my word be that proceeds out of my mouth. It shall not return to me void. It shall accomplish what I send it to do, and it will prosper in that thing that I send it to do." See, now, God says His word will surely come to pass. Now, I'll show you an example. Genesis chapter 15, when God spoke to Abraham. Now, look at this carefully. Genesis 15. Now, God had promised Abraham a son. And remember, He told Abraham, "Come out of your father's house unto a land that I'll show you." And Abraham obeyed Him. And then one time, Abraham got a bit discouraged and said, "Lord, what are you going to give me?" See, that's this whole Genesis 15. "What are you going to give me? I don't have a son. My servant is going to inherit all these blessings that you've given to me." And God began to assure him that, "Look, I said you have a son and you're going to have a son." Now, look at something God said to Abraham in verse 13, Genesis 15 and verse 13. And He said unto Abraham, "Know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them 400 years. See? Now, God is speaking here. Remember, at this point, Abraham did not even have a child yet. And then God is saying, "Look, your seed is going to be in a strange land that is not theirs. And they are going to serve those people." And then He said, "And they shall afflict them 400 years. And look at what God said in verse 14. "And also that nation whom they shall serve, I will judge. And afterward shall they come out with great substance." Did you see that? Now, I want you to notice what God said. See, because number one, when it comes to prophecy and prophecy interpretation, you see, God speaks and His word is truth. But most times, you know, dealing with human beings and dealing with believers, you will get to understand that the problem most times is the interpretation of what God has said. It's not about whether God said it or not. Many times the problem is the understanding of what God has said. And let me tell you the truth. If you don't understand what God has said, then when the prophecy is fulfilled, you will not even know it. And that's where a lot of people find themselves. That's why Proverbs, it says, in all your getting, get what? Understanding. Because that's what you need the most. Without understanding, you cannot work in a perfect relationship with someone. Husband and wife have had issues just because of misunderstanding. See, in other words, the husband said something, the wife understood something differently. And then there was a problem. Praise God. I've got to stop here for today. But see, this is what we're dealing with now. Notice where we stop, because we're going to continue from here tomorrow. God told Abraham that your seed is going to be in a foreign land for 400 years. And after that, he's going to visit them. Now, we're going to start up from here tomorrow. Praise God. Listen, I pray that the Spirit of God will guide your steps this week. The reason he's bringing these things to you is because there are certain prophecies that he has spoken about your life that is about to be fulfilled. That's why I'm sharing this with you. So get ready and be expectant, and God bless you. Have a wonderful day today. Bye-bye.